circuit of a classic audio tone control. I have published it earlier on YouTube, but I wanted to make it again, try it, make another demonstration. It's in my book, one of my books, and that book is Schematics to Audio Amplifiers and Loudspeaker Boxes. It was sold many times anyway. Here is that classic audio tone control circuit. It was, as far as I know, developed in the 1950s. And in this video, I will give some ideas how you can change the sound properties in an experimental way. At first, it's important to tell that you need a one transistor amplifier that is connected to the audio filter here, because that filter, like all audio filters, have loss. So the energy in, the audio in via a MP3 player or whatever, a CD player, etc., etc., will give loss due to the filtering. The filtering limits, in fact, the energy. So you need a one transistor amplifier here, supplied by 12 volts. And here you can see that one transistor amplifier. Don't get impressed by this contraption. Not at all. I only use one transistor out of this 3-transistor amplifier that I've published earlier. I only use one stage here, and that one stage, that's important, has an electrolytic capacitor of 10 microfarad on its emitter. And on its emitter also a 1K potentiometer, and in the collector lead a resistor of 2K2, 2200 ohms, or 3K3, 300 ohms. They are here. This is of course the audio filter. I've explained that much, much more in other videos anyway. And here is again that audio filter. I want to demonstrate the sounds later in this video. And you can see here that I've made an experimental extra capacitor of 6 and 8, so 6800 picofarad, that bridges the 47 nanofarad capacitor. In these filters you will always see a kind of symmetry, 4K7 here, 4K7 there, 50K, 1N5, 1N5, 33 kilo ohms, 3300 kilo ohms, so that's 1/10, etc., etc. And when you study it, you will find much more information, for instance, on the World Wide Web. I used here 50K potentiometers, but they can also be 100K. Of course, with 100K potentiometers here, the circuit will, the filter will act somewhat different because of the higher resistance in combination with the capacitors anyway. Here is that one transistor amplifier. It sets the amplification here, 1K, the 1K resistor, in combination with 3K3 or 2K2 anyway, out audio. And I've used, by the way, the 3-transistor audio beginner's amplifier that I have published earlier. I want to refer to my earlier video. And that 3-transistor amplifier is here. And on the background you hear the music. And here is that filter in practice. You can see here the two 50k potentiometers, and I've soldered parallel to the tiny capacitor of 1N5, a big capacitor, and here also another capacitor. You can see that here I say here that that is a switch, but in practice I've now soldered here 6N8 and 0.57 microfarad parallel to that capacitor. And of course these two capacitors will give an enormous effect on how the sound is reproduced and how that classic audio tone control works. So let's see what happens. We have now the maximum sound, and I turn that potentiometer here. The sound starts to be sharp. And now this one in the middle position. And now we look here what happens when we do this. The level goes down, also the sound presence goes down. And here again, a demonstration. It's very strange here, we have a kind of middle position. That has all to do with the symmetry of the filter. I cannot explain that better. Study it, for instance, on the World Wide Web. This is, by the way, completely classical audio filter used in the 1950s and the 1960s and the 1970s by Philips and all kinds of other manufacturers. Anyway, here is that one transistor amplifier, and you can see when I turn that potentiometer on the emitter, there is also a very good effect on the sound, and that has everything to do with the properties of such an amplifier and the whole circuit as a whole. And you can find much more information about this in my book Schematics to Audio Amplifiers and Loudspeaker Boxes on the Lulu website. Maximum amplification. Let's turn these potentiometers again. Here again, that kind of node where the sound is pressed down and gets up again. Anyway, again the other potentiometer. You can hear the effects, surely. So let's go to the drawing of the circuit. I made a drawing. By the way, this is the circuit in my book Schematics to Audio Amplifiers and Loudspeaker Boxes. Very important to tell that you have to send the filtered signal back to the first stage. So from the collector here, 3K3 or 2K2, back via the filter unit to the input. Otherwise it will not work. So So this is the drawing. I want to pen over somewhat. $100K is preferred, but of course you have listened to the properties of this filter, and surely $50K will also do that work, do the work, proper filtering of the audio signal. I will take somewhat more distance. Switch off the sound. Hinders a little bit. Here is the drawing. Hope it's clear. Seen from this distance. Pen over somewhat. And here the experimental switch. Do some experiments. It's always very interesting. For instance, you see here 47 nanofarad. Try to change it to 100 nanofarad. And here you see 47 nanofarad. Do the same. And at the same time, listen to the sound that the filter produces. Whether it fits your needs or does not fit your needs. What you want to hear out of the loudspeaker box. 1N5 1500 picofarad is a very small capacitor, and here that extremely big capacitor parallel to the tiny capacitor. Anyway, the only idea is that this is a properly working circuit, and with some experiments you can get out of this filter all the properties that you need and want. In your living room, for instance, when listening to music,